Hi students, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about series and parallel combination of capacitors. Consider three capacitors C1, C2 and C3 and they are connected in a series manner. Three capacitors are considered here and these three capacitors are connected in series manner. Here the capacitance is C1, here C2, here it's equal to C3. And these capacitors are connected to a voltage source V. Now the circuit is closed, so the charge begins to flow through this circuit. When the charge reaches here, this plate attains positive charge. At the same time, it attains by induction, the second plate attain negative charge. Okay. The charge present in between the plates of the capacitor is Q. Okay. This charge again begins to flow through this. So that the second, okay, this plate attains positive charge and here it attains negative charge. The same amount of charge again flows through this, through the third capacitor. So, one plate attains positive charge and the other plate attains negative charge. So, we can say that in series combination of capacitors, charge remains constant. Therefore, the first point is in series combination, charge remains constant. Charge constant. Then, what about the potential? Because of the difference in capacitance of these three capacitors, the potential drop across each capacitors may vary. Okay, depending upon the value of capacitance, the value of potential in these capacitors varies. We know that VQ is equal to C into V, therefore V is equal to Q divided by C. Okay. Here the value of capacitance varies, so the potential also varies. Okay, then what about the potential across the capacitor C1? Potential across the capacitor C1 is taken as V1, that V1 is equal to Q divided by C1. Then what about the potential across C2? Potential across C2 is taken as V2, V2 is equal to Q divided by C2. Then what about the potential across C3? Potential across C3, that is V3, V3 is equal to Q divided by C3. Okay. Then what about the total potential? Here the applied potential is divided into 3 and it appears across these capacitors C1, C2 and C3. Therefore the total potential V, okay, or the applied potential V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Okay. Now we can substitute these values in this equation. That is, V is equal to Q by C. That is Q divided by C equal to, instead of V1, Q by C1. That is Q divided by C1 plus, instead of V2, Q divided by C2. Q divided by C2 plus, instead of V3, we can write Q divided by C3. Okay. Now Q remains constant everywhere. So that get cancelled. Q get cancelled. Then what about 1 by C? 1 by C is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. Okay. In series combination of capacitors, 1 by C is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. And this capacitance, this effective capacitance is taken as Cs. Therefore, 1 by Cs, Cs for series combination of capacitor. Then 1 by Cs is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. Okay, what will happen to the effective capacitance here? Effective capacitance is the reciprocal of all these capacitors. Okay, so what about the effective capacitance? Effective capacitance is smaller than the smallest value. Okay, in series combination of capacitor, effective capacitance is smaller than the smallest value. Then what are the important points regarding the series combination of capacitors? First point is charge remains constant, and the second point is voltage is divided according to the capacitance of the capacitor. Okay, then third point is effective capacitance is smaller than the smallest value. Okay, now if all these capacitors C1, C2, C3 are having same capacitance, that is C1 is equal to, C2 equal to, C3 equal to C, then what about 1 by CS? 1 by CS is equal to 1 by C plus 1 by C plus 1 by C. That is equal to 3 divided by C. 1 by CS is equal to 3 divided by C. Therefore, CS is equal to C by 3. Okay. Here, CS is equal to C divided by 3. Okay. If 4 equal capacitors are there, then what about CS? C by 4. If 5 equal capacitors are there, C by 5. Okay. If n equal capacitors are there, then what about CS? CS is equal to C divided by n. Okay. This equation is also very important. If n equal capacitors are there, then CS is equal to C divided by n. Okay. That's all about the series combination of capacitors. Okay. Now, we move on to parallel combination of capacitors. Okay. To explain parallel combination of capacitors, again we want to take three capacitors C1, C2 and C3, and these capacitors are connected like this. The first capacitor, second one and third one. Capacitors are connected in parallel manner. Okay. Here the capacitance is C1, here the capacitance is C2, here it's equal to C3. Okay. And these are connected to a voltage source V. Okay. Now the circuit is closed. Then current begins to flow through the circuit, or charge begins to flow through the circuit. When this charge reaches here, when the charge Q reaches this point, the charge flows through this way and this way. And the charge, the value of charge flow through these branches are based on the capacitance of the capacitor. Okay, based on the capacitance of the capacitor, charge flows through these branches varies. Okay, so here we can take it as Q1, here Q2 and here it is Q3. Okay. Therefore, in parallel combination, charge varies according to the capacitance of the capacitor. Okay, charge flowing through each branch varies according to the capacitance of the capacitor. Okay, then what about the voltage? Okay, the terminals of C1, the terminals of C1 which is connected to the voltage source V. C2, the terminals of C2 is also connected to the voltage source V. Terminals of C3 is also connected to the voltage source V. So, what about the potential? Potential or voltage across each capacitor remains constant. Therefore, the most important point is in parallel combination, voltage remains constant. Voltage constant. Okay, what will happen to the charge? Charge varies according to the capacitance. Okay. Therefore, the charge from the battery Q, that is divided into three portions. So, we can write Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Okay. Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Okay. We know that what is Q? Q is equal to C into V. Okay. When the charge Q1 flows through this capacitance C1, then we can write Q1 is equal to C1 into V. Okay. Charge Q2 which flows through the capacitor C2, then Q2 is equal to C2 into V. Then what about Q3? Q3 Q3 flows through the capacitor C3. Therefore, Q3 is equal to C3 into V. Okay. Now, we can substitute that values in this equation. Then, CV is equal to Q1. Instead of Q1, we can write C1V plus instead of Q2, C2V plus instead of Q3, C3 into V. Okay. Here, voltage remains constant, that is taken outside, C1 plus C2 plus C3. Okay, CV is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3, VV get cancelled. Therefore, C is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. Okay, in parallel combination, the effective capacitance is C1 plus C2 plus C3. Okay, here the effective capacitance is taken as CP. Okay. For the parallel combination of capacitor, effective capacitance is taken as Cp. Cp is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. Okay. What about the effective capacitance here? Effective capacitance here is the addition of all the capacitors. So, what will happen there? Effective capacitance is greater than the largest value. If this capacitor is having 1 microfarad, this capacitor is 2 microfarad and this one is 3 microfarad. Then what about the effective capacitance 1 plus 2 plus 3? That is equal to 6. Okay, 6 microfarad. That is, this value is greater than the largest value. Here the largest value is 3 microfarad. Okay, the effective capacitance is larger than the largest value in the circuit. Okay. Therefore, what about the important points in parallel combination of capacitor? In parallel combination of capacitor, voltage remains constant. That's the first point. And charge is divided into 3 according to the capacitance of the capacitor. And the third point is effective capacitance is larger than the largest value or larger than the greatest value of the capacitor in the circuit. Okay, now if C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C3 is equal to C. Okay, C1 is equal to C2 equal to C3 is equal to C. That is, all these capacitors are having same capacitance. What about CP? CP is equal to C plus C plus C. That is equal to 3C. If 4 capacitors are there, CP is equal to 4C. If n equal capacitors are there, then what about the effective capacitance? N into C. Okay, in parallel combination, effective capacitance is equal to n into C if all the capacitors are having same value of capacitance. This point is also very, very important. First point is, what about the Cp? Cp is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. Then, if n equal capacitors are there, Cp is equal to n into C. Okay, I think this topic is clear for you. If you like this video, please subscribe and enable the bell button. Thank you.